Okay, welcome everyone for this Teams Day online. It's a 2 days program. It's a really awesome program. They are doing a lot of work and bring a lot of speakers here, and we are learning a lot of new things from Teams, right? Thanks for joining. Today I'm going to talk about build and deploy Microsoft Teams messaging extension app. We have give introduction about apps, and I'll start with give the demo how to build and deploy and the real life, what are the things you need to use. I'm Jenkins. I'm founder and director of JPower4. I'm an office development MVP. I have 16 plus years of experience. I'm specialist in Microsoft Teams, Power Platform, and SharePoint framework. I'm an international speaker with different events and conferences. I'm an author, blogger, and trainer. I'm an organizer of SPS Bangalore and AOS ambassador also. Yeah. If you anyone have any doubts or clarification after this session, also you can able to connect me using my Twitter account or LinkedIn or my email ID. Okay. Always I'll rest ready to help anyone. Okay. Thanks for joining. We're going to start my agenda. Today we are going to give some introduction about Teams a little bit. And where we are going to use about the apps for development. Okay, where we are, our line of business, how we are going to use our apps, because we are going to develop, as they say, nothing but extending our out of box Teams. Okay, this Microsoft Teams messaging extension and action commands. It's the first time I'll show you how we are differentiating with the action commands and the search command part. It's all task oriented. Okay, whenever someone want to do some activities and share to the other person, let's say something to start to share your team, that time you are going to use message extension. I'll show you. And finally, you can go with a link and referring message extension. Just what is Microsoft Teams? I think last yesterday fully you are see about Microsoft Teams, right? The hub for teamwork in Office 365. Its the main purpose is communicate, collaborate, and work with confidence, full security because of its title coupled with Office 365. Okay, out of box, we have a lot of features. We have, we can able to connect different application because right now it's around 400 apps we are able to connect from the out of box itself. But whenever go for any application or any tools we are using from Microsoft or other vendors, always we need to extend our own line of business, right? Microsoft Teams is the biggest compared to in the market right now. Teams is the best platform to collaborate with any application, not only Microsoft apps or Microsoft application. We can able to integrate your application to third party Salesforce or Dynamics 365 or SAP like that, wherever you want, where your data is there, where your application are running, you want to bring your application inside the Teams for your collaboration, your daily activity, you can able to can go with Teams, right? That's the main thing. And we can able to extend all our application with customized, or you can able to use the same application as a URL from your channel. Okay. Yeah. Where we are using, say we have a different type of app, the ready to use apps by Microsoft, that is nothing but Office 365 applications like Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Notepad, Power BI, Forms, Planner, SharePoint, everything is integrated. What are the Office 365 products are integrated? And above that, we can able to see GitHub, AdHub, Trello, Poly, like that. More than 400 applications are there. That's the apps we can able to use, to register it, and you can able to use. Or if you are already have an account, you can able to use that. And the second level is we need to use our own custom application, right? Our own department tools, our employee resources or support information, process and workflow. That is always important, right? Whatever the existing thing is fine, but we need to utilize our line of business, daily activity, what we are doing. We need to integrate. That's the main purpose. We are extending our application. It's an organization based app application. In every organization, we have a different scenarios, right? One is vertical part, one is horizontal. It's nothing but all the departments come like finance, airlines, whatever it is, all the vertical industries, whatever your industry, you can map it, right? wherever it is, no problem. Teams will support and all these extension also support because it's highly secured and fully governance application. You can able to set your own governance in Teams. That's a always is a big advantage of this application. Then horizontal, both the specialists and HR, project management, all these internal team or departments, we can able to implement our apps. All everywhere we can able to, because existing applications also available by Microsoft, and we have app templates ready to go with production. That's introduced by Microsoft, and a lot of community members are developed and published there. All Microsoft reviewed and published. Okay, that's why you have a very good chance to use the Essence application if you already don't have a knowledge. If you have a knowledge, you are ready to learn, do all with Node or C Sharp or Visual Studio Code, whatever it is. You have a technology, you know, React or in the client side, or the C Sharp or VB.NET like this server side, you can able to do this application. Okay, extend your teams. Okay. For extending team, first you need to know what our app look like in Microsoft. Always you remember that you need a place to deploy your code in Azure. That is not immediately required. We have two options. Locally, you can able to execute. And the secondary option, we need to deploy for permanent, right? It's a production ready. Then you want to deploy in Azure. And you can there deploy and publish. Then you can able to access from your any teams. Wherever you want, you can able to access. Okay, that's accessing point. We need to create an app package. That is app.zip file. In the left hand side, you can see, right? We have a manifest.json file with two images. The two images, nothing but where you are accessing, that I'm representing your application to identify, right? That logos or image we need to bring. That's a two images. With the manifest, we have all the information because we have different type of apps like bots, messaging extensions, tabs, webhooks, connectors like that. We have different apps. Now we are going to talk about only Microsoft Teams messaging extension, but message same like bot app, a message extension app also utilizing the bot framework. That's a, because of it's internally it's communicating with application like a bot. Okay, and the application side we have whatever the business logic or background job, whatever you are writing, that's your end, right? That's the coding part. The coding deployed in Azure and build and publish, and it will communicate using the bot framework channel registration. Okay. First, I can tell you what is message extension. Most if you are new to Teams and you are unable not used message extension before, I just will show you. Okay. Message extension is nothing but whenever I want to get some information and share to my team inside my channel, that scenario I'll go to messenger. This I'll show some example in our teams. Okay, for example, any teams, whatever teams you have, if you go for a conversation, right, whenever going to conversation, we have a lot of icons in the bottom, right? These all comes as a message extension. Okay, messaging extension, because we are doing some message. For example, I'm hello team, I'm doing something the same time I thought of it, I can send some information to my team. If you want to send some reports, or you want to some identify some places and share to them, or you want to do some appreciating to the team members, okay, you can use the praise app. It's all out of box apps. I'll go show you how to use the custom nest. First, I can show you where the message extension work. Okay, for example, I'm say awesome to which member. Okay, say for example, I'm using some member, I'm saying I give some notes, keep great work. Like that, now I can send and preview. I'll verify that and send it. Okay, that's I can some you can be able to appreciate like this. We can share the task also, right? Whenever I want, I can send the task to the team members. If you are mentioned someone names, it will automatically information notification sent to them. And also it's highlighted in the activity. Okay, once it is sent. Okay, you send, right? And also you can able to all this social GIFs you can able to use everything. Okay, the same time if you want to do something more actions on that, you can able to use these. Okay, more action. These are the messages. Okay, for example, I'm creating something like create a UCU or add a command or something. You want to have a license, you can use it. Okay, likewise, we can able to use it. I'll show you all these things. Okay, you can sign in and use any application. Jira is not our Microsoft application, right? It's a third party application. You can able to use that. Okay, now the second point is here, two types of message extension available. Okay, one is messaging extension with action command, nothing but when you have some particular task you want to get or particular data to search and get it and send to users, you can use the action commands. The second one is you have a search commands. That's nothing but when you go and search something detail and we can get it. Okay, for example, I want to get I'm have an example to get from the Google books. If you have a ISBN number, I'm searching ISBN some number 987 hyphen some book now ISBN number. Then I get all the books related to that. I can find that which book I want. I can select it. The first one is totally different. You can able to get the only one item. Whatever the result come, we can able to get a particular item and send it. That is action command. That's a both are difference. Okay, and it and message extension. The good point is it support. All the most of the cards, okay, adaptive cards, hero card, list card is not supported, connector card and sign in card also not supported. Other all the supported by Teams, all cards are supported by messaging extension. That's a good thing because of when you go bot, we have some restriction. When you go tabs, we have some restriction like that. We have wherever the cards supporting features are different. Okay, all the apps have a unique identification. That's always remember that. Okay. I'll just go and do the example. Or we are going to build it, right? Okay. Always you need a first thing is you need a Azure bot framework. That's a bot channel registration. I'll do it fast. Okay. Let's go to my portal .azure.com. You can register our bot channel part. Okay. Okay. I'm going to my Azure environment. I'm signing that and just show you how to register it and then I can create a app for you. Okay. This and creating a resource. Here you can say bot channel registration. Then you create the bot channel registration. Here you need to provide a unique name. Okay. It's already it's a public bot handle, right? That's always you need a unique name to identify. Okay. I can say Teams Day Online. Okay, that's also supporting. That's okay. And I can select some resource where you want to store. There you can mention and location. And you can always select for if you're a development, you can use F0. This is a free of cost. S1 is you need to pay for that. That's a development purpose you can use. And the message extension part. You need to provide a proper HTTPS URL. Okay, for extension always look like this app messages API/messages. Okay, here we need to provide the URL of the domain. Okay, here I'm going to use ngRock because ngRock it will expose our HTTP localhost to HTTPS. That's a signed URL that's it mentioned. That's a secured URL, right? Because Microsoft Teams support only HTTPS. That's the reason I'm using. Later we can replace it. Okay, just I'm copy the URL and place it here. While developing, we can replace. Okay, application insights, we don't want that right now. I can select app and I think not required. Auto create is enough and create it. It's a simple step to create the channel registration, right? Oh, after created, in the meantime, I'll open my folder where you are. I can create one folder for this application, Teams Day Online Demo. Okay, that's a folder I'm creating and I'll move back to that folder because always we need it. When you developing any app for Teams, we have different environment is there. One is Visual Studio, which are the C# development, and on next one is Visual Studio Code with the template development also, and also we have a Yo Teams. That is the template Microsoft already accept it from the community, we can able to use it. Your team, that's easy to develop, because we don't need to create our manifest file. It's automatically create for you. Okay, this time we create your teams. The meantime, I'll check with my resource. Where is it? We can see. Yeah, go to resource. It's already done. What are the thing is need to do is once created the Azure particular what channel registration, you need to expose the channel first. Okay, otherwise it will not available for you in the teams. Okay, first channel, you can have multiple channels to expose by Microsoft. Okay, any bot application. Okay, here I'm exposing with the teams. Okay, I'll click the teams icon and save it. Here you can say commercial, and if you are a government, you can select government. Okay, otherwise save it, agree, agree. Okay, now we got the item is exposed. And one more thing we need to do after saving this. Okay, I'll save, then I can go back to my settings. Okay, once saved, I exposed to the teams, right? Now we, at that time I can able to verify also. Okay, with the web chat I can say verify and test it. It's running, or you can able to see my teams and web chat are there. And settings, the settings part, you need to go here. The messages are already there. Next to that, you can see Microsoft app ID. Just copy this app ID and paste it to your own notepad, because it is ID required. And then click the manage icon. There's a link is there. Click that and go and create a secret. That's a password, right? There's a secret, client secret. Just go here and click new client secret. I can say Teams Day Online. Never and add. It's creating the particular value for you. Just copy it and paste it with where you are saving the ID, right? Like at the same place you named it. Because we need to add in the Visual Studio code where you are developing code, right? We need to code that. Okay, once done, that is right, you create it. Okay, now we are going back to here in our application development. Here, what I'm saying, I can say what's the solution name. Teams Day Online Demo and current folder, title of the Microsoft Teams app project. Then I can say get books, then your company name and version latest, partner ID if you have, you can provide. And you can go here and remove that. You see tab and go here, message extension comments. Using the space bar and get selected. Okay, then message extension command, select it. Now here you can get the URL, right? Here, leave it now, we can later modify. If you are have a domain proper name, then you can able to provide this using your Azure websites or .NET or your own domain names. Okay, then here I'm loading indicator, I don't want. And test the initial script, don't require inside, not. Okay, here what I do is, my bot hosted somewhere or I have a new bot. I can say yes, and here I need to provide this app ID. This app bot ID, right? I can provide this ID. Okay, now enter. Here I'm selecting the action-based messages. So first I'm going with the action-based. Okay, based on the time, I'll do the search also. Okay, here I, because of it's action-based, right? I can say use command bots and if you have a compose also fine, because both of us will work whenever you use. It's a command bus, it's a normal every time we can enable. Okay. Okay, then I'll go here and command bus. Here you can select adaptive code. Which type of you are a task model you want to create or static properties, you can select. So we are now this example, I'm using adaptive code to respond, represent it to the user. We have option to task module also. We can able to send a task details from the task module, and also static properties you want able to use. Okay, and here I'm not using any authentication. We are able to use Graph API authentication, everything we can able to select. And setting message extension, yes. Here I'm get boost message extension, right? I can say get books. And description about get books, and we can create it. Okay, now it's a application as creating. It's a simple process, right? We got this Azure part done already. Only thing is we want to give in the Azure environment, you need to mention the URL. Okay, after execution. Okay, we need to replace the URL. Other than that, everything completed from the Azure end, the bot channel registration. Here you created the application. It's creating less little time it take. Don't worry. Okay, application is created. Just one minute. Yeah, our app is created now. Okay. Now what I do is I'll give code space dot. I'll open my Visual Studio Code. Okay, what editor you like, you can use it. Here I'm using Visual Studio Code. First thing, I go to the environment env file because I need to update my app ID and secret ID. Okay, there I can copy this secret ID first. And I can place this password here. Okay, and wherever the app ID required, you need to update. Okay, let's say here also it's automatically updated. Here also after updated while we created, you entered, right? That's the reason it's updated. Okay, now we got these data. Just save it. Now, then what I do is you can go your manifest and I'll show you what is that. Go to the source file. You can see the manifest. We have the two color icons, right? You can able to replace for your own. Okay, and you can see the by default the manifest created. If you have no idea how to create it, just you can able to create using dot dot and app studio. You can able to create a manifest for you or existing one. You can able to modify also. Okay, that's another option to do it, but your teams, it's always help you to directly create for you. Okay, no need to do manually. By default, it support you and create the app. Okay, here the context or command bar, right? You say have it, everything is there, leave it. Okay, now we got it. With the first task is fetch task, true is running. Okay, now I go into the code and just modify some of the things. Okay, just go into my code here. Okay, by default, some action is there. Okay, what I do is I can change to my code. Okay. Because of time constraint, I'll explain anyway. Okay, let's say I'll copy this value. Okay, I can say these things too. Yeah. Okay, what I did is please enter the ISBN number. That's the window will come. You need to enter, use the information to user and get it. Once submitted, after submit, I need to get the action point. Right? The action point also, by default, we have the some information. Let's say I'm going to change in our code. I'll show you what need to do that. Okay, once action point, here I copy this. What I do is here when you submit, user enter the ISBN number. I get the ISBN number from this particular action point and get the ISBN number from the user and pass it in the Google API URL and getting the value. Okay, the first value I'm getting. And what I do is I'll get the title of the information, everything, and buy it in the adaptive card. Okay, I'll display everything in the adaptive card and getting. Okay, just I'll save it and I'll run this application. I'm executing the application. Okay, I'm using ngrok-serve. The main reason is I'm going to change it and get the URL. Here you can see the ngrok URL. I've got it. Just I'll copy that and maintain in my Azure place. Right? Just I replace my ngrok URL here. Okay, and save it. Okay, we'll click that auto focus, then save it, save from here. Now the channel, bot channel is ready to accept from our local code to execute and available for our teams. Okay, once the completed, it's doing everything, right? It's application done. You can be able to see the code there. What, where is the path I'm using? Using day online at SPFS. Can see. Teams the online demo. You can able to see that package is there. You can see the demo .zip file. If you want to know this, just I'll copy and show you what's there. It's nothing but two images and one zip file. Let's say extract here. Okay. You can see one manifest file, one outline, and one color. Okay, that's nothing but the images. The same manifest file what we created there with the proper URL, with the ngRock URL there. When you are ngRock URL manifest file in our code, it's look like a getting that value from env file. Okay, the environment file. Okay, that's available now. Okay, now we are application done. Any errors we can see, no errors, then you can able to go and add this app in our application. Okay, I'll go to my teams apps to just I'll go here my apps and upload the zip file to deploy in our teams. Okay, just go here. You can see the bottom, you can have upload a custom app. If it's available only, if it's enabled for you, then only able to see. Okay, and create, I'll do it for my whole organization. I'll take this path and select my zip file. Okay, just I'm adding, it's deploying in my teams. Okay. Okay, now we got this app is ready. It's the GetBooks app, right? We deployed. It's ready here. You can select it, add it to your team also, or you can want to directly can get it. Okay, it's loading. Yeah, now it's asking the ISP number. I can give some ISP number, right? One second, I have. Yeah, I can copy the ISP number and paste. I'll use the full ISP number and paste it. I have the ISP number. I can click OK. You get the value here. Okay. Now I get it from the individual part of it. Okay. Now what I do is I'll go my teams and add the same thing. Okay. Go here. Any teams. I'll go my say manage team and go apps. Here I'm adding more. Here you can see more apps. And click the app here. Get book, right? And open that. One second. No, no, my teams. Why it's not enabled? Teams. Manage team. And I'm adding the app. Upload a custom app. One second. I'll one second, there we can check the manifest. Maybe the manifest not having a permission to team level. The scope you need to verify. One second, I'll try again. We have 10 minutes. I don't. I'll try deploy again my Teams. Maybe it's not deployed. Just I'll go. Okay, I think the team is not adding. Okay, what I do is I'll add the other part also, the search command, then you can able to see where is the problem. Let's say adding the search part. Once you go here, normally we have the scope with that, and then okay, I'm modifying the commands part to searching part. Okay, search for that. Okay, then I can save it. The thing is, where for searching part also I need to add the code for that. Okay, I can add the to ready the get the value. Okay, whenever I'm submitting the fetch task, we need to modify based on that. Okay, because of the user going to search it, right? Before that, he got the pop-up, and the pop-up we are enter the ISP number. He search it and give the data. That's the action command. The particular action it's happened. Okay, now what I'm doing is I'm going to modify the search part. Okay, let's say I can add the one more query part. I'm adding the another method. Okay, let's say from after completion of this method. Okay, I need to add one header also. This is voting. Because of my attachment, I need to pass using the message extension. That's why I'm adding the header here. Okay, this already we have the bot builder. I can add message extension attachment also. Okay, just save all. It's running again already. Okay, what I do is I'll stop it and we'll see. If you are running again, for example, that's the reason I stopped. If you're running again, it will, the new URL will generate, because if I'm using ngRock free version, if you are using a license version, then it's the same URL will be there. A new URL, let's say, one second, the manifest we need to check. Okay, yeah, as I'll save all. Now it will work. It will create a new URL. You can be able to use that. Okay, just copy that new URL and paste it in our same Azure part. Okay, that's it. We have a bot channel, right? Just modify it, because of development purpose. Whenever you are doing using the same URL and modify the code and verify, fine. Suddenly you are going back and stop the application or any error throws, the URL will change. That's always remember that. Okay, that's the reason I've stopped and do that. Okay, now I think it's a proposal. Oh, okay, one more method I need to add. One second, let's see. And just I'm copying with the sample code with the see. Yeah, just so we replay back that command. It's using my card. Okay, I'll share this code to everyone. Sorry. Adding that code and save all. I'll go here. It'll work now. We have a little time. I'll complete now soon. Okay, this time not required to change the URL because I'm not did anything in that code. Okay, just save anything in the manifest. Manifest only you need to modify. Okay, the same thing I'm using. Okay, just because it's not running fast. That's a time constraint. I'm running again. Just copy my URL and updated my bot registration. Save it. I'll come back here. What I do is now done, right? Just I'll go here my teams. I'll just go the app sessions, all apps. Just I'll remove that because of I'm going to replace, right? It is not a new version because I'm running again, right? So if the other ways you can use the same, it will already we need to override for the production time. Don't worry, we can able to use the same domain name, right? That's the reason it will not affect anything from our end. Okay, just I'll go here. I'm adding again is the same zip file. Yeah, it's deployed. Now what I do is I'll go here and it's not adding team. Yeah, it's coming here, right? You can be able to see the searching power window. It will be there. Okay, now we get see. What I do is this is in the search your messaging assistant part. I'm going to get the ISP number and search it. Okay, just copy the ISP number. I can use the number. I can get the list of item related to this ISPN. And I can be able to select it and I can send it okay to the user. Okay, this I'm using the hero card. The previous one I used the adaptive card. Both different experience, right? That's why I'm trying to use the different cards. You can be able to use any cards. The same like you can be able to see the same search option will be there. For example, ISPN, I can say colon something like different number. For example, we have a lot of books in the market, right? I can say April SharePoint. Some ISP number I'm taking from the Google. In one of the book, I can copy the ISP number from here. I think they say available here. Yeah. Just copy the ISP number and mention here. Okay. Now I able to get the new book list. Okay. What are the books? Just select it. You get the book and send the details. Okay, the book title and the description of the book. You can show more. You can able to see the detail of it. Like that, you can able now. You can understand two ways: the action commands and the search commands. Able to using our message extension app. This same functionality we can able to use for our real life task management. If you are using Jira or something other application, Azure, DevOps or Planner, you can get the details and share to the corresponding team member or your channel members. You can able to share the details, status, everything using the message extension. It's available in the particular area. This is the main thing, and also available here in that dot. You can able to see here also because of it's not in a team, right? If you enable team, then the channel, then it's able to there also. Okay, there's the two places you can able to see the message extension app. Okay. Everyone got it. I'm done with these examples. Okay. Any questions, anyone? Anyone have any questions? Okay. Okay. And one more thing is we have other one option is the final one is having a linked one, right? Let's say in the first slide I can mention, right? That is nothing but when you want to do some URL to share the user and that URL I make it as a proper data from that site and give use to the user, then use the link unflurring message extension. Okay, that is nothing but if you have a Wikipedia URL or something, whatever URL you are sharing, for example, copying this URL and sharing in my team, what it will do, simply share the URL to the user, right? It will not bring any auto-populate information like detail about this URL. It's just you bring the basic information, right? If you want to detail about the from the page some information you want to gather, then use that link. Just you need to add the information in our manifest file with the what are the domain names you want to publish. You get information and then use the adaptive card or hero card and bring the value to the end user. Okay, whatever the URL you are sharing, same domain available here, then it will automatically bring it. Okay, that's the three things is done. Okay. Okay, now I'm done with that. Share your feedback and also whatever questions you have in the messages and snap. Not only that, any development for Teams apps, you can contact me. Always I'll ready to help. If you are doing some development, use my contacts or use my Twitter or LinkedIn accounts. Okay, you can able to get it. Okay. Any questions anyone have, let me know. Thanks for the sponsors, because of the we are here. They are providing a lot of, and all the organizers and volunteers. Thanks everyone. And thank you. Any questions? Yeah.